Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Same shirt, third video I believe. In this short one I'll give you 17 tips that will help you in Once Human. Let's dive in. Acid. Find a way to make that passively. There are some good tutorials online for that. I won't go over it because it would take too long. But Sulfur Chemist. Get this memetic if it's presented to you and I think you'll be able to just make acid from sulfur and energy link. I'm always starved for acid level 50. Always. Can't craft, can't calibrate, everything needs it. Just find a way to get it other than killing and looting enemies and you are set. Did you know that powering an isolated securement unit makes your pulse recover mood and power faster? Also, throw a red light on them since you're here for an extra 5% bonus. Skill rating of these guys reflects on the quality and quantity of their work. This one, for example, is skill rating 4. Let's see how much of a difference it makes when compared with my other guys, skill rating 3 and 2 respectively. All have wires connected for electricity and red lights and were placed into the securement units at roughly the same time. Just use copper ammo if you still need materials for other things. The bonus damage of the expensive ammo is cool and all, but not needed really. I did all content the game has to offer so far with copper ammo. Electric furnace doesn't use charcoal, so we'll not need as much wood anymore. I regret not researching this earlier. Chainsaws and electric drills are also good quality of life improvements. You'll get plenty of materials. If for some reason you don't have deviations that passively give you wood and the basic ores. I saw this water pump and I have no idea if this mechanic is implemented or not, but reading the description made me place my rainwater collection systems up there, so the collected water goes downhill by the power of gravity, you know. But if you can't do that, just use one of these small pumps, place it on a wall and your water can go uphill. When you're doing a rift anchor area objective and are desperate because you don't find the last weapon crate or mystical crate and have any sort of missions nearby, just do the missions. The devs placed some of these area objectives within these story mission areas, so you stumble upon them and not pull your hair out. In this one, for example, I was looking everywhere. I think I've searched every building outside while the damn box was in these tunnels all the time. If you shoot someone and your bullets don't make contact, just move a bit. Odds are the collision is blocking your shots. You know when you can shoot a target when its health bar appears. You can't shoot through most fences, for example.
Did you hear that?
The NPCs in this game are blind and deaf. They need to have clear line of sight for you to be detected. So abuse that. For example, they can't see you through windows. Don't teleport all over the place because that consumes energy link. Move your house often and be more strategic with your movements. This is for the early game. Late game, you don't worry about energy link anymore. This ties up nicely with the previous tip. At some moment in time you will have more meme points that your energy link can support, so you can't just spend them all at once. That's why it's important to save that as much as possible. Don't stress over it, just don't calibrate every piece of gear and weapon you get and just keep doing content. Securement silos, all events, puzzles and riddles, rift anchors, elites, bosses, everything rewards you energy link. You can even trade crafted food for energy link. If you see glowing parts on any NPC, just shoot them. It's highly likely that's a weak spot. The wish machine, don't gamble, just buy the blueprints. The Starchrome doesn't come by so easy as far as I saw, but if you dislike gambling, just stay on it until you can afford what you want and pull the trigger that way. With my new weapon, I could craft the tier 4 right away, but I think I will craft it when I unlock tungsten bars in a couple of levels. There is a significant material sink if you do that at tier 4 now and again at tier 5 in a couple of hours. What I'm trying to say is, if you don't need an upgrade ASAP, don't craft something that you know it will get replaced pretty soon. Take a second and watch some posts from other players that are left near some objectives, because most are helpful and can save you a lot of time. There is an option somewhere to disable these because they can be annoying, but I'd say leave them on. Mystical crates are often high on top of buildings. But my tips on finding this are: read some of the posts around the place, of course, but try to figure out what's the main building in a village or small town. What's the mayor's mansion? Or find the most imposing building and look for it there. You should find at least a weapon crate in most of these, if not the mystical one you're looking for. Do the puzzles as they are very rewarding and pretty easy to do. I did this one in a clinic where I was hearing this phone ringing. It's a bit oversimplified for the modern audiences, but short and good payout. Bikes can climb almost vertical hills. Yeah, if you want to get on top of some hill, don't try to do it on foot. Just do what I'm doing. You can make this juicy shellfish meat with shellfish, of course. That food is pretty cool and very easy to make. You need water, sugar, and one shellfish a pop. Just mine some shell rocks around red sands. Just be aware it degrades pretty quickly. Now, if you found value in any of this and fancy the type of content I'm making, you know what to do. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care and see ya.